Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
Delicious things to eat.
The popcorn can't be beat. The sparkling drinks are just dandy. The chocolate bars and the candy. So let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat. Let's all go to the lobby.
What up?
What up? YouTube,
baby.
Overalls.
Yeah, keeping it going. Even though my baby spit up on it.
Now you can blame all stains on your shirts on the baby, though.
Yeah.
I had like soy sauce all over a white sweatshirt. I wish it could be like a fucking baby who's eating Chinese food laying down on the couch. Get soy sauce all over my sweatshirt. A messy baby.
There are some stains you still cannot blame on the baby.
Like what?
I think you know.
I don't know. I don't make those kind of stains. I'm clean.
Oh, yeah, right.
This is the first stream I've done in like a week where like I added a bunch of sound drops that can be controlled by chat, and they are like, I've got like not PTSD, but I hear them in the back of my head all the time now. They're all like cut from like Alien movies. So it just like drops sound drops from Alien movies. And they come so frequently that like, that's all I hear when I close my eyes.
Can I do my soundboard?
Yeah. It's your show. You get to do whatever you want. Cigarettes! Yeah, cigarettes. Timmy may be here tonight. He had a football game. He's playing, he's a fullback? Comeback?
He's a comeback.
if you're watching the show and don't follow me, Nate Blackest on Twitch. We've had some fun this week playing some shit. Welcome to Trailer Boys. How are you, Sam? I haven't talked to you in a bit.
All right,
Boys in a bit.
Did that?
yeah, that worked.
All right, that worked.
Sam, what do you think of that? Okay.
What do I think about what?
Sam, what do you think of Timmy's football game tonight that he was a comeback on? They did win. Okay. Oh. Fun.
Cool. I think that's it I have for the sound effects.
Maybe. So welcome to Trailer Boys, everybody. This is a game show kind of thing where we watch just the movie trailers because movies are too long. This.
I'm very sensitive.
Yeah, I love that one. That's from Trailer Boys. That's reference.
Yeah, that's a Trailer Boys. Yeah.
So, you know, some movies are really bad, but they'll have like a good enough trailer, you know, and that's what we're here for. You know, like I've been watching a bunch of movies, watch parties on streams, and a lot of these are not good. And some of them are tough. And Sam, we watched, was it Valerian? Was I with you when we saw Valerian on stream?
I did not watch Valerian on stream.
Well, I mean, but you saw the trailer when we watched Valerian?
I don't think so. See, I was on 2 weeks ago and I came up with this theme and I heard it was one of the best themes.
It was super fun because we found like a lot of like sci-fi schluck, and one of the movies that was played was the trailer for Valerian and the City of a Thousand Planets or something like that. And so we watched it and I was like, I have generally good feelings of this. Let's watch it. So we did it in a watch party and it's crazy. You know, like how your mind like picks the good stuff and then throws away all the bad shit. Cause it was rough. It was a rough, rough movie to get through.
Oh, you saw it before.
Yeah.
And you went back for more.
Yeah, but I had COVID, so my memory is not what it used to be. So
Don't blame COVID. COVID gets so much heat these days.
Yeah, it's an easy... I'm just looking... See, babies, COVID, I'm just looking for excuses for things. But man, it is a rough, rough movie. I apologize to chat for watching that with me, but dang, it was... The acting was bad. They kept going off on like a B storyline for like no reason to add more visual stuff. You know, there were cool parts. There were definitely cool parts. Visually, it was amazing. The story was real bad. And they kept having to like tell you what was going on in the story over and over again. And then by comparison, I was like, we need to watch some good movies. So the other night we watched Sunshine, a Danny Boyle movie.
I've not seen Sunshine.
It was good. I don't want to hype it up because it definitely has some flaws, but like, visually it's amazing. The music is great. Underworld does the score. The acting is really like Chris Evans is really fucking good in it. It was a fun movie. It was a fun movie. Running Man we watched. Running Man was fun.
Captain America?
Yep.
Captain America's in that movie?
I was telling you earlier, I don't know if you saw, but like Captain America is from Massachusetts because, you know, obvious reasons. But Chris Evans.
Because is, obvious reasons.
Because Massachusetts is America.
That's
where America started, right? You know, Plymouth. I'm just kidding. It'd probably be like Philadelphia or something, right? But I worked with a lot of people that are friends with Chris Evans, and they were telling me last night, I hadn't seen him in a while, and they're like, yo, Chris Evans loves Barbarian. Tell your friend.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay, so
funny,
we watch movie trailers and then we have a theme. It's not just any movie trailer, we will have a theme, and tonight's theme is dinner party, like dinner slash cooking family stuff. Like, we're, you know, with Thanksgiving coming up this week, so that was kind of a loose focus. So that's the theme tonight. And where do we get the trailers? You, the audience, submit you, the
audience. Yes, you, the audience. Hello.
That web URL up there, and you put in your name, and because you put your name in, because we give out points, and there is a leaderboard.
Your
name,
your sex, your location.
It's called ASL, not American Sign Language. Right now, look at this, Sam. Oh my God, Flanja, previous, I think season two winner? Season one? No, season two winner, Flanja. Is in the lead right now with 20 points. Beach It Makes You Old, 16 in second. Boner Honk Farts in third, tied with 16. It's pretty close.
If you thought this was luck, this isn't luck. This is skill-based.
That's proof right there. We have a lot of these names look familiar, but we're still early in the season. This is season four. We just started. So if you're just joining us now, you can still get in. People may remember Big Row 1 came in halfway through season two, and got into the tournament. So I haven't seen Big Row 1 in the chat very often, though. Maybe they blew all their trailer load. It's funny with season
they
three
had it,
winner.
They lost it.
Season three winner, Guy Incognito, still submitting. It's like, you won. You can take a break. Still submitting good stuff. So that is how we do it. Last week's theme was set by Sam. It was like hard sci-fi movies, like real, not like genre.
A loose definition of hard sci-fi, because like hard sci-fi, I guess, is sci-fi that has real, that's based in real science.
Yeah.
And what I was pitching was world building sci-fi.
Yeah. So. It was a fun time, you know. It was a good week. We saw a lot of movies that like looked identical.
Right? Now it's time for them.
What's the time for?
I was just sorry.
Mike Hard Sci-Fi. Yeah. before we get into the rest of the show, I want to say thank you to Pop-Tart 3697. He resubscribed and said, or they resubscribed and say, my favorite day of the week, Sunday, because that's when he goes to church. Blackbird Flew resubscribed for 21 months, said, loving the coveralls, Sam. Well, coveralls have sleeves. Coveralls is like your full like jumpsuit. Overalls is more like a bib situation with suspenders. That's the difference.
Yeah.
Hedora. Hedora 225 dropped 5 gift subs in the chat and then also cheered 100 bits. There you go. Caro Kansas resubscribed for 25 months. Flans resubscribed for 21 months. Says happy Sunday, everyone. Sack Miak. Sack Macaque. Sack Macaque. That's how to pronounce that. Follow the channel. Okay. Let's see. I think that's it for resubs. Did I miss anybody? All right. How was your week, Sam?
It was good. Went on a big run today. Had some of Emily's family visiting this week.
Fun.
Sold an NFT last night.
Oh, yeah.
I showed it on stream. It wasn't up for sale for long because someone snatched it up.
Snatch.
They snatched it. How far was your run, Sammy? It was 7 miles.
You should do snatch drawings for NFTs.
Ooh.
Like people grabbing things?
Yeah, people grabbing things.
Quickly?
Yeah.
Can I show you a video?
Sure.
It's not trailer related. Is that okay with chat? Chat didn't answer in time.
I might have to mute this. Turn this off. All right. Yeah, sure. Show me a video.
Okay. Let me see if this works. If I do it like this. That's loud as shit, huh? All right, hold on. Let's see if this works. Nope. Let me see if... Nope, this does not work. All right, here we go. Can you see this on the stream?
Yeah, yeah. Am I supposed to hear it?
It does have audio. This is, I went and saw Turnstile last night, and it was a huge new venue, and this is a straight up mosh pit, going nuts to I Want to Dance with Somebody.
That's funny.
Yeah, going nuts. And then, hold on, there's that video. I want to show
but one. You said more. It was like a Taylor Swift crowd, but yeah. It looks like only dudes.
In the mosh pit, definitely. It was a lot of big dudes, but like around wherever. I was telling Sam earlier, like the kind of deal with the band. They used to be a Philly hardcore band, but they put out a real posy album.
That's short for posited.
Yeah, and so now they have a bunch of like Taylor Swift vibe. All right, so here's the start of the show, and I want you to like focus. Like this dude comes out of nowhere from behind the stage and does a stage dive, and it's fucking like it's like 6 feet. It's crazy. All right, watch him come out from behind the drums. There he is. Look at that. Boom! Did you see that? I don't know if you guys saw that in chat, but it was pretty fucking crazy. I think I tried to get like a slow-mo version of it, but I don't know if it's saved.
Tessa Glass says, I once started a mosh pit at a Free Sublime show, one of the best nights ever. That's also Tessa Glass hates Sublime and all their fans.
Well, that's how you do it. All right, so check this out. I just want to show it again. Here's this guy's just boom. Like, that's crazy. Anyway, It was a super fun show. If
wait, does he flip?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, crazy.
Yeah, it was pretty nuts. It was like, it was, it's a brand new venue. It was very, very cool. It's called Roadrunner in Boston. If you're near the area and you see a band and you want to see them and they're playing, and you're like, oh, that's that band. And that's that place, Roadrunner. I would highly suggest going to it.
What if you don't like the band?
Then I wouldn't go to it. I wouldn't go to it. The lights were crazy and stuff. See. So this was the end of the show. This was pretty nuts. Just fucking crazy confetti. Like, it was, it was pretty fun. And it was great. It's, you know, for older crew, all the shows end at 10 o'clock. So we got to see Snail Mail open for them. But it was an event. It's pretty fun.
So was there someone there that kept farting?
Yeah. I mean, that was me. You can tell because I'm really close. I had like, I had some really like, I had some Chinese food that was dubious. You know, it'd been sitting out for a while, and I think it gave me some gastric distress. Michirichi says, well, I saw Turnstile last month, and then the chat moved, and I didn't see what it said. Somebody tried to crowd surf, like, during a slow song while they were talking, and they got dropped immediately. That's pretty funny. I love that, when people, like, fail on the crowd surfing. The venue is huge, but also, it's a hardcore show in Boston, so, you know, the biggest people you're going to come out to for hardcore shows are going to be in New England. I think Converge was their opener show and it was sold out. So it gets pretty nuts. Frank Howley is raiding with a party of 32 people. Sam, you haven't done a Frank Howley raid song in quite some time.
I'm very sensitive.
Well, Sam's very sensitive about that.
It's a Frank Howley raid in the town. I almost grabbed my bass, but I was like, oh, it's in the case. It's a Frank Howley raid in the town. Everybody don't worry, he's gonna get down. Frank Howley raid in the town. Frank Howley raid in the town.
Oh, Thicken Wing just gifted Frank Howley a sub. Thank you, Thicken Wing. Can you turn the sound effects up a little bit?
Oh, yeah, sure.
I'm very sensitive.
All right, that's good. Chat, can you hear that? Chit, can you hear that? More farting, please, Bitcoin says. Bam, 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 bam. Do you want to see what won the sci-fi show last week?
Yeah.
Are we ready for that, or do you have more?
Do it.
All right.
Okay, yeah. Wait, nice.
Hold on one second.
What's wrong?
It's not going into the watch screen for some reason. Let's see?
Oh.
There we go.
You screwed it up with your thing.
Also, I've clipped this. We'll be using this graphic soon.
Oh, cool.
On the edge of our galaxy, there is a battleground where alien warriors compete for the ultimate prize.
I am champion!
Will a human do battle in the arena? Now where is the challenger?
Where humans have lost.
You ever thought about the arena, Steve?
It ain't gonna work. This guy's a human.
What it takes to win.
You're talking about arena fighting. It's not for me.
We'll be right back.
Oh, what a good gag.
Listen to them, Steve. They're calling for you.
You've got speed. You got muscle.
You could go right to the top. You're going to work for me.
Nobody tells me what to do.
Nobody puts baby in the corner.
Someone tried to poison him.
Sorry, kid, but I'm afraid your fighting days are over.
So I was like, that looks like the Ferengi guy. Like the rapper. Yeah. Turns out it actually was him. It's the actual actor.
Oh, that's funny. From Deep Space Nine?
Yeah.
Now we kill him.
Yeah.
Arena.
That looked great.
Yeah, I think Timmy and I are planning on doing a watch party of that when he has time. I think we got to schedule something, but so if you are a chat person and you're like, I hope these guys do another watch party sometime, that is looking like it might be the movie that we do. But yeah, no, that of a lot of good ones, and they all had like great names. Arena was like pretty, but there were like Star Crash, Space Wars, like they all blended together to me. So that was one that, I enjoyed.
Oh no.
What?
You got an OBS thing over my face.
That was on purpose. I'll fix it in a second. There we go. Yeah, that was a neat thing that we did. Do you have any coming attractions?
Yeah.
Okay, you want to get into it?
Yeah, let's get into it.
Oh, that was the wrong button.
Oh. Ready?
State University. The recap.
Now it's
time
for the 80 for Brady starting lineup.
This is 3 minutes
Lily Tomlin,
long.
Wayne State University. The Rita Moreno. PS132.
Sally Field, Birmingham High School.
Jane Fonda, college dropout.
The 80 for Brady trailer starts in 3, 2, 1.
It's a 30-second
this time.
Oh,
free trailer.
All right, Gronkowski.
We know, Trish. We've all read your Gronk erotica.
It's not erotica. It's fan fiction. Very sexy fan fiction.
Aren't you tired of the same old boring lives?
Let's go to the Super Bowl.
The Super Bowl is no place for four old women.
This could be Tom's last one. He's almost 40. That's like 80 in people years.
Yeah, we're 80 in people years.
I just really need this trip.
I can't believe we're actually here.
Taking this one. He's cute.
So you don't have any tickets?
How much for four?
10,000.
10,000?
Well, I have a 20 in my strap-on.
That's a fanny pack.
If you wear it like this, it's a strap-on.
Wow.
They went there.
It's so great to meet you. Beauty has no expiration date.
Krish. I didn't flirt. He did.
There's so much here to do.
We could even win these tickets.
This is a spicy wings contest.
Bring the pay!
I could use a little spice.
Oh.
I know her!
If you black out, is who this... you want me to call?
An ambulance?
Ow!
If you did this,
oh,
to give
it comes
us
out February, so
hi,
it won't
honey,
be eligible for the Oscars this year.
You think you could get us in?
Follow me. These are my dancers.
Prove it.
What dance moves you ladies know?
A twist. A jerk.
Let's do it.
Hey.
Gronk.
Hi.
So big.
Thank you.
Isn't that what friendship is? That we face the unknown together?
Let's go, Golden Girls.
Come with me.
Do you think they all fuck Gronk?
Right, Mark. Oh,
come on
no,
now.
Oh, wrong punches.
I just wanted to.
Let's go!
Oh my God, that's
Todd!
It's his only line in the movie.
These are good.
Very good.
Oh, careful, they're high dosage.
High dosage?
Oh.
Excuse me, I'm looking for someone.
Are you okay?
Guy Fieri.
Wow. That's really cool.
That looks great.
Did you see? How did they do that? How do you think they made so many Guy Fieris?
Cloning.
Yeah. That may be one of the best trailers we've ever seen.
Watch it again.
It had a 30-second pre-trailer trailer.
Yeah. Only a 30-second pre-trailer trailer.
That is insane.
Spinning Hook, thank you for the resub. Richie, thank you for the resub.
Okay, well, I got another one. Ready?
Yep.
You have a choice still.
Oh, wait, this might be a fake trailer.
It may not be the life that you imagine. But perhaps it will be the life that God
intended. Oh, this is definitely a fake trailer. I got duped.
I've been waiting my whole life for this.
We need a Barney with the graphic
trailer. Yeah, it's definitely not the Barbie trailer.
I know, but like, it looked great. we need a button for when we get duped for, because it happens too much where we get duped for fucking... Sam, rule number one is watch your own trailers.
What?
Penwell came up with that rule. And he won the first season, so.
All right, here's one.
Lady Sink is such a hard name.
Do you ever get the feeling people are incapable of not caring?
Disagree. This trailer looks bad. Does this trailer make you want to watch this movie? I know it's like a teaser trailer, but good damn.
It just I want to see it.
Yeah, I'll see the movie.
Did you see how fat he is? Nate, I think maybe
it's CGI, right? Is it a fat suit?
Did you see how fat he is? I think it's partially a fat suit.
I think he
gained a lot of weight, but like, I think it's also like,
look, I gained a lot of weight too. Nobody's giving me a standing ovation. Okay. nobody's calling my weight gain a triumph. Okay.
You're just waiting for that right role though. All right. Here's one. Here's a full one.
Oh, it's your mom. Okay. Hey, Mrs. C.
We were just in the middle of eating.
Yeah. Jesse, what do you want for Christmas? I already have what I want. True love.
Jesse, I think I'm holding you back.
What's this guy's name?
Are you breaking up with me?
Is it Beck Bennett?
Baby, we did things
no,
right.
No, it's not
know?
Beck Bennett.
We got the fights
the
clean and
one.
The sex dirty. I mean, you keep that pussy so fresh. I'd be happy to keep servicing your needs if it won't complicate things.
Alex Moffat.
I just spoke to my son, breaking up with you right before Christmas.
Yeah.
Sean doesn't want to come home. That's fine. But your family, Jesse.
Mr. and Mrs. C.
It feels right to be here.
Bah, humbug, but that's too strong, because it is my favorite holiday.
Oh,
my.
Hello. Christmas Story guy?
Yeah, and there's another Christmas Story coming out.
Liz. God, if you were 2 years younger, we'd have to try not to get pregnant.
Hey, Becky, nice to see you.
Remember when we were kids and I threw my whole cookie jar at you?
I should probably help with the,
lights. Have you been standing here the whole time? Hello. Yes.
I hope Jesse's having a good time.
They're having fun.
Who's that accent?
Take a sip of purple drink.
Is this...
safe.
Just enjoy the moment. Have a nice glass of lean together.
I haven't done something this spontaneous in forever.
Yeah, way more cough syrup at the moment than grape soda. Oh, yeah.
Very full body. Mm-hmm. Is it too much?
Not at all.
Now she is trying.
I saw George Wendt at a Replacements concert.
We are dealing with a top shelf Christmas flat.
Jesse.
It's like it's meant to be.
Whichever path you take, I support it. I know that Sean can be wild sexually, and I want you to know that that comes from my side of the family. I'm sorry.
Thank you for sharing that with me.
It's important that we stay connected during this busy holiday season. So, drop those lights and pull out your dick.
What? You keep leaning out of frame. What? I'll definitely see that. That looked good.
Yeah, it looks like a fun holiday.
A lot of redheads. Yeah, a lot of not real redheads there. I thought it was odd. And why is Justin Long like all of a sudden like this like love interest leading man character instead of like an awkward goof?
Well, he wasn't the love, not like spoiler, he wasn't the love interest leading man character in Barbarian. Silent Alley said depends on how you watch Barbarian. All right, so we got a bunch of trailers here. They're all dealing with food.
Dinner. Hold on, let me see the thing real quick. Sorry. Let me get to the list. I've not listed. Let's see real quick. Just adjust something so it makes it cleaner for us. Have you seen any movies this week, Sam?
I watched Eastern Promises last weekend.
Ooh, what'd you think? How'd it hold up?
It's great. It was better than I remembered it being.
I had the opposite with Valerian, but then Sunshine was better than I thought it would be.
I really want to watch Crimson Tide for some reason.
Oh, I was thinking a thing like we keep thinking of movies and we're like, oh, and this movie and this movie. So what I did was I would think of two movies that kind of had like a similar thing, you know, like I put up a poll and the poll was two movies for each thing, right? So it was like Pandorum and Sunshine and Dune and Blade Runner, and then like Aeon Flux, the live action, and then Total Recall, the remake. And then people voted, and then it went to a vote off between those two. But I want to watch like you know, some of the twin movies together, you know what I'm saying? Like Deep Impact, Armageddon.
What's the twin movie for Crimson Tide?
For October.
Oh, I guess.
I mean, they
didn't come out. They came out years and years apart.
Let's see.
They both came out in the 90s. I think one came out in like 1990 and the other one came out in like 1997 or. Lydia Petunia, stop. Are you looking this up right now?
Yeah, I thought. Did you find a movie you want to watch?
Oh! I didn't know that.
I thought you were going first. I was like, yeah. Fred October. You wouldn't call that a twin movie? I feel they're kind of in the same.
I think they're siege. Made so far apart, though. What, like, when were...
They're 5 years apart. I love Crimson Tide, though. Denzel Washington is so fucking... James Gandolfini.
Viggo Mortensen.
Yeah, that is a stacked cast.
Yeah. Gene Hackman.
Is he still alive, Gene Hackman?
Yeah.
He's got to be like one of the greatest actors of all time, right?
Yeah.
He's underrated.
Yeah. You ready?
I'm ready. Let's start the show.
All right.
I'm sending you to California, Fort Spencer.
We have four missing soldiers, Captain, and no bodies. We need a supportable explanation.
Captain John Boyd is out to solve a mystery.
The music is so just weird.
Ends up at Fort Spencer. We come for a reason.
And yours being?
I totally thought this was going
to
be...
But he is about to discover...
We have a great sense of camaraderie here at Fort Spencer.
Fitting's Clearwater Revival.
Something he never imagined.
Winged Eagle.
It's an old Indian myth from the north.
Man eats the flesh of another. He absorbs the other man's strength.
Now, one man must choose.
We need others.
Between having dinner.
Not me.
And being dinner.
Good gracious.
Man, this is a really annoying.
Stewie, a la Major Knox.
The trailer makes it real Guy lighthearted.
I'm gonna kill him.
Yeah.
Robert Carlyle.
He was tough, but then a good soldier ought to be.
Jeffrey Jones.
He, wanna bring you into
is
the fold.
Is that Rob Zombie?
David Arquette.
Yeah, that song.
There's no guilt. I gotta eat. But it's tough making friends.
Eat to live. Don't live to eat. Huh?
That was really sticky.
It was licking me!
Ravenous.
Bon appetit.
Hey, hold on. I saw something. Music composed and performed by Damon Albarn. I'm going to have to re-examine that because I pretty much love everything Damon Albarn touches. So I'm going to have to check out the score to that. So that was a fun trailer for me because I thought, you know, I've seen the movie and it's like a dark movie and it's not like a light comedy. And so the music and the voiceover was like, it put it in a different vibe. So it was very, very fucking weird. So that's very funny. What do you think?
Okay, time out. Message in the chat. Hello, I'm Automated Imbecile. Bad name, I know. And I submitted the Valerian trailer. Sorry the movie sucked. I only found the trailer for this show. I tried for weeks to get that Twitch account verified, created a new one, and got verified under 2 minutes. I'm horrible with names. It's my birthday, so I can't stay. Might join later. Take care. And that's from... Hard Spumoni.
I'm going to say thank you because like the watch party of Valerian was fun. It was fun. It was such a bad movie, but it was fun to watch with people, you know? It was long, but I mean, it's a gorgeous movie. So thank you very much. Don't apologize.
And then Thick and Wing gifted Hard Spumoni a sub Thick for their birthday.
You shouldn't have done that though. It wasn't
that good. It's their birthday.
Yeah, well, they should have done a better trailer. No, I'm just kidding.
That was a really funny trailer. The comment is, with numerous dinner jokes in the trailer, really fit in the theme. That's great. A cannibalistic cult classic, dark comedy gem of the late 90s, dope cast, Guy Pearce, Robert Carlyle, David Arquette, John Spencer, and the ever problematic Jeffrey Jones.
Yeah.
I like that rundown of it.
I'll say, people in chat, we have a new chat system we're trying out. You just type a number in chat and it does the votes. We're trying to get a better chat that has a visual element so you can actually see the chat going on right now. So Ravenous in chat, all you have to do, you don't have to click on anything. If you're somebody that's like, oh, the chat didn't load for me, it doesn't matter. You're just typing in chat, onesies, twosies, threesies, foursies.
This is confusing. Because it's ones or twos. I'm in our own system giving it a two, which means yes.
Okay, I'll fix it next round.
Not a two like you guys, which means no.
The one problem I have with this is it doesn't end. You have to manually end the chat, the poll. It doesn't count down in seconds, and that's what I would like it to do. But this is something we were trying out. My thing, and I do like the metrics of it. We have 44 people have voted. We have 218 people watching the show. So I tried to make it as easy as possible for people to vote. So I'm going to end the poll now. And it looks like it got we still have votes coming in.
All right. Can you have it be a Y or an N?
Yeah, I can do a Y, like hit Y or N. I don't know.
Like hit Y for yes, N for no?
No, I think it's only onesie twosies.
Oh, okay.
But 3 minutes seems like a good round number to end it. 3 minutes seems like a lot for poll. The poll's always been a minute long, though, you know? So yeah. I'm just going to end it. And okay. It got 76%. That's 3 points for Ravenous off the top. Sam, what do you give it? I'm giving it a 2 points. I feel like as a movie, I don't think the movie was that great. If it was a straightforward trailer, maybe not that great because it was a fucking weirdo trailer with weird music and like that voiceover and like one-liners.
Yeah.
The shittiness and weirdness of a trailer made it good for me. I'm giving that 2 points.
He was licking me.
What was it? What was the line? It was like, you either be dinner or you make dinner or something. All right,
so that was 7 point. That was a 7 point trailer off the top for Almobes.
Almobes OTT off the top. Good job, Almobes. Chat, give me a number. Give me a number between 1 and 76. Okay, let's see. Okay. Let me fix one thing for the next thing. Okay.
The people at this party are the proverbial cream of the crop. You're talking buckets of money and connections and influence everywhere.
This house is fantastic.
And this is just the foyer.
Well, vampire?
You'll see.
This house is so weird. Maybe we should just go.
Stop. Our host Stop. Is so weird.
Sorry.
He's wearing a cloak.
How often do you have these dinners?
These secret dinners. We did take the precautions we talked about on the telephone.
Yes. No one knows we're here. In fact, they think we're on vacation.
I love the when the audio is bad when you're hearing the room echo.
Straight for Broadway.
You guys are in for a surprise.
You know, like that?
Yeah.
It's time. Killing you is not nearly as elegant as what we have planned. We need you.
What is happening?
We all do.
Shall we begin?
The dinner party.
That was like, I don't think I've seen a crappy movie that has looked so close to being like a good movie.
Yeah.
Not that that looked good in any way, but like, it looked like so close to legitimate, but also at the same time was like completely like, no. Also, if you get invited to a dinner party and they're like, yeah, tell everyone that you're on vacation, don't tell anyone you're here, they're going to try and kill you.
Yeah, that's that. They're just, you know, they're giving it away.
Yeah.
Don't fall for it.
Yeah. All right. So ones are no's now and twos are yeses.
Yeah, that's all we'll do. It. Ones are no's, twos are yeses. For this movie, personally, I am going to not give it any points. It was very flat to me.
Yeah, I think
it was like, that's a good point. Being spooky and elegant. But then you didn't really get any of the, I kind of have like, I know it's just a trailer, but I do want a little bit of motive, or even at least like superficial motive, you know? All right. Been up for a minute. Should we do 2 minutes for the polls now or no? Is that too long, you think?
Do you want me to do a timer?
When this thing says 2 minutes, I know it's over. Like I did notice that like the seconds were counting up to 1 minute. So once it's 2 minutes, but I just wish it showed me what the seconds were on it.
Oh.
So I can hit it in, but we can just do
1 minute.
Yeah.
People can't tell you how long they want it to take right now though. Cause they'll accidentally vote no or yes.
Well, I'm sure they've already voted. Right. All right. No, that got 67% no, which means 1 point, 0 points for me.
0 points for me.
Okay, so that got 1 point from Chit, and that is going to Muncher. Sorry, Muncher. So if you haven't picked it up, what we've been trying to do in our effort to not double down on people, so not one person's getting a ton of points per round, I've tried to sort people by name so we're all together so we don't accidentally do it so your names are there. When I ask you for a number in our randomized section of the list, I will see your name and then I'm choosing one of your submissions. So Muncher did submit like three things, but I feel like two of them we've already watched and that's what we went with. So that's how we did it. Just giving you a little behind the curtains. Am I ready, Sam? Yes, I am.
So, now you're not listening, I can tell you about Albert.
Prince Albert?
I thought I could tell you eventually, but I'd have to get to know you a lot better because...
But what's the movie called?
Well, because I'd be so ashamed.
Here's your chance to improve your table conversation. Tell Mike you live in a big house and you spend £400 a week on clothes.
I spend £400 a week on clothes.
You eat in the best restaurants.
I eat in the best restaurants.
Georgina, try a little harder, please.
It's important that I tell you now so that I can have done with it.
This is my wife, Georgina Spicker. She's got a heart of gold and a body to match. And I am Albert Spicker, and I have a heart of gold and a great deal of money to match.
Albert beat me. Well, you know that. You saw the bruises.
Pâté d'alouette with the chicory sauce.
Pâté d'alouette with the chicory sauce.
Oh, yeah, that's Dumbledore.
Terrine de Canton.
Ooh.
It's Dumbledore?
Cold turkey with a lemon and basilica.
Cold turkey with a lemon and basilic. If someone give you a prairie oyster to eat, what do you think you'd be eating?
Fish.
Now, Mitchell, you have just eaten.
Kind of looks like it, but I can only see the top half of his face.
Yeah, I know. Oh, yeah, it is.
And next time I ask you to work for me, Mitchell.
All right, is this TOS?
I'm expecting you to chew someone's buttocks off on demand.
All right.
He had a suitcase under his side of the bed, and in it he kept all kinds of objects.
Yeah! Get rid of that!
Don't do that to a woman!
I do what I like to a woman!
Is that his twin brother? Bloody trouble.
Your beautiful eyes, Georgina.
And you have a beautiful prick, Mr. Gynecologist.
What the hell do you think you're doing? I tell you, a complete stranger! Intimate details about us!
Oh, help me, Michael. Please.
I saw him kissing you.
The title, Doing Work. Yes.
I saw him kissing your breast.
No, don't do that!
I saw him put his hand between your legs.
All right, stop it.
But now, today, all this must finish.
It's what it is, a revenge killing, an affair of the heart.
Between us. We must finish him for good.
I'll bloody find him and I'll bloody kill him! I'll bloody eat him! I'll kill him and I'll eat him!
Help me, Michael. Please.
It's Dumbledore?
Yeah, that was Dumbledore. That's TOS, guys.
So is that a minus point?
That's a minus point.
All right, someone get a minus point.
It's my enemy, too. Sorry, Schwingles.
It's hard to keep track of your enemies, though. I was like, oh, Panini.
Wait, isn't Schwingles my enemy? Oh, no.
You have so many enemies. You and Schwingles patched it up.
I just figure we gotta do the minus one on that.
Yeah, we have to keep it fair.
You know, it was very grainy, and there was a couple moments where I was like, okay, the bra, okay. And then eventually it was like, oh.
Is it kinda, a good movie?
I've heard of it before.
I've never heard of it. The cook is Timmy, the thief is Zach, his wife is Darren, and her lover is Sam.
Okay, cool.
All right, my turn. Chat, give me another number, please.
Actually, I have to go watch that movie. So Helen, I'll see you later.
Helen Mirren.
I'll just be back in 15 minutes.
Okay. You're going to watch the movie in 15 minutes? Wow.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to watch the movie in 5 minutes and take a nap for 10.
Okay. All right. Oh, this is sometimes I'll see one in here and be like, oh, I bet this will be a popular one, and be like, oh no, it was only submitted once. So,
Marty Pascal is bringing his new fiance home for the holidays.
I hear his car. Marty!
I'm Jackie.
There's only one problem. He hasn't told his twin sister.
Leslie and I are engaged.
Did you give your sister her medication?
Her name is Jackie.
Did Marty tell you about me? How you were? How's that?
She lives in a white house.
When they came out of the room, Jackie's hand was holding Marty's.
And she's got her own ideas about family values.
It's the wildest place you've ever made love.
I can't talk like that about your brother.
Pretend he's not my brother, I do. Marty, you're home.
Now, she's about to put her house in order.
She doesn't seem like Marty's type.
They're getting married, Jackie.
The phone's dead.
Don't look at me.
Are you spying on us?
Mother doesn't spy. A mother pays attention.
The New York Times calls House of Yes a screwball comedy.
Oh, my.
And Parker Posey is laugh-out-loud funny, says the New York Post.
One more time, Marty. For old time's sake.
I'm going to go baste the turkey and hide the kitchen knives.
Parker Posey.
That's a good line.
The House of Yes.
Ooh. The House of Yes. The House of Yes. Have you seen that, Sam?
Yeah.
What did you think of it?
I thought it was funny. I haven't seen it in a long time. I saw it in college.
I haven't seen it in a long time either. That was the movie that like I rented from somewhere and then like took forever to get it back, and then it was like $75 in late fees or something. That's my only memory of that movie. I do love Parker Posey though. Voting is open. Yes, guys, voting is open. Thank you.
One means no, two means yes.
And I who's the guy who plays Marty? He's like an indie actor I've seen in some shit, right?
Yeah, yeah. He was in Kicking and Screaming. He was also in Eighth Grade. He played the father in Eighth Grade.
Eighth Grade was really good. I was impressed with that.
Yeah. He was really good in it. Josh Hamilton. Yeah. Thank you.
Josh Hamilton. Was he also in Lars and the Real Girl?
Nope.
No?
I don't know.
Was he in The Coward Robert Ford? Is that what that one was called?
I don't know. I don't remember him being in that.
I wish there was like a website that was like a database of like internet movies. Like an internet movie database.
He was in Tommy Boy. He was in Seven. He's in Free Willy.
Oh, yeah. He's a Noah Baumbach guy. Was he in Mr. Wonderful?
Angie.
Not Mr. Wonderful.
He was in...
Mr. Jealousy.
What's that? Rush Hour. He was in Schindler's List.
Wow. 63% yes, Sam.
That's 1 point.
What are you giving it?
1 point.
I'm going to give it 1.2. So it's 3 points... And those 3 points are going to Abby Sally. Big fan of the Naked Brothers Band, Abby Sally.
Okay.
Okay.
Ready?
Ridley P. Wizard says, hey, I love your work. Thank you. I didn't know you were paying attention to the work that I do. It's not very interesting. It's like an office job, but, you know, I'm pretty good at it, so I appreciate it. It's nice to be appreciated.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
Welcome. Welcome, welcome. Ready?
Yep.
Henry Hollowhead is the daddy dude, working all shift just to pump home the food. United Umbilical is where he works, the best meter reader this part of Earth.
The Hollowheads, an average tubular family. They've pumped along happily for years until...
Yes, dear, dinner. But you'll never guess who. My new boss.
My promotion is just around the bend.
Oh, Henry, that's wonderful news. After this shift... Oh,
this has got the same, like, time thing going on.
Honey, yeah.
Like, I have not seen that the whole time we've been doing the show. In fact, we have two trailers.
The day Henry Hollowhead's boss came to dinner, the waste really got ducted through the vent spot.
Don't think of me as your husband's boss.
Oh, that's the kid from River's Edge and Near Dark.
Oh, yeah. Juliette Lewis.
You must have loved her deeply.
Often.
I'm just going to a party with some of my friends.
When the boys get a look at you, they're going to trip over their own tubes.
What is that guy from?
From flowing along in the slow hose, the hollow heads have been charge-piped into life on the edge.
It looks like it could have been played by Paul Rubens.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah, it seemed very Paul Rubens-y.
Boss is lying there on our kitchen floor. Do you know what this means? It means I don't get my promotion.
Uncle Leo?
He has to okay it.
Life on the edge. You've never been anywhere quite like it.
It's a different world.
Oh, that's true, dear. Now it just sucks by itself.
Huh. Is that Mama Fratelli at the end there?
That's what I was thinking. And that wasn't that guy in the Gremlins 2? The dad wasn't the dad from Gremlins 2?
It's called Life on the Edge.
I'm going to make a weird, like, for some reason, this guy, I always recognize this guy in movies, but I'm going to make a weird call out.
Delightful domicile, Holloway.
The day Henry Hollowhead's boss came to dinner, the waste really got ducted through the vent spout.
So that there, that's the kid from Near Dark and...
I don't think it is.
River's Edge. You don't think it's the kid from Near Dark?
Don't think of me as your husband's boss.
But that's not the call out.
Think of me as a very close friend.
This guy here, he was the, and this is my guess, he was the guy that checks them into the video game contest in The Wizard.
I feel it. Yeah. I just,
for some reason, I've like recognized from the guy that's like, they're like, what game are they playing? And he's like, Ninja Gaiden.
Somebody find that video.
So, what is Life on the Edge?
Or Meet the Hollowheads. I have it up on IMDb. I want to see the video you're talking about. Oh, Sam, you're right. Joshua John Miller from Near Dark. That was him.
Yeah. Or Meet the Hollowheads.
He wasn't Uncle Leo, but he was in Seinfeld. That's fucking hilarious.
Oh yeah, it's Lee Ehrenberg, who's from Pirates of the Caribbean. He's with the guy that played the guy from The Office. And what year was The Wizard?
Lee Ehrenberg? I don't see him in the... Oh, wait, there we go.
Oh yeah, Armageddon Registrar. Armageddon in 1989. He played the Armageddon Registrar in The Wizard. I think I might. I think
first things.
Yeah,
wow, I mean, he has, like, Sam, that is a deep call out.
And he also played. He was also on Seinfeld.
No way.
Yeah. Played Mike Moffat.
That's Wasn't funny. The actor that we were just talking about also named Mike Moffat? The guy from trailer? The guy from SNL?
Oh, no. That was Alex Moffat?
Alex Moffat, still. Man, that was a pretty cherry call out, Sam. You do get the propers for that. You do get the propers. Damn. All right. So that was called Life on the Edge, which is an odd title.
Meet the Hollowheads. Yeah. I give that 2 points myself.
All right, sorry, polls up now. I keep going back and forth on that one. Let's see.
And I maybe you're forgetting this, but I don't know, this might jog your memory.
Hollowhead is the daddy dude, working all shift just to pump home the food. United Umbilical is where he works, the best meter reader this part of Earth.
Like the whole thing starts out with a rap that sets up the characters.
Okay.
That's why I'm giving it 2 points. I mean, it's fun aside from that, but that was so over the top good.
I'm looking for the scene in The Wizard with like the Armageddon guy.
We don't need to.
I just want to hear it, the voice.
Super it's before Mario this.
Brothers. Oh, it's before this. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Poll ending now, and that got a 67% yes, which I feel is low for this movie. I'm surprised, 43 voters. I am going to give it 2 points as well. So
6 points to
5 points.
I'm giving it 2 points. You give it 2 points, and Chad gives it 2 points.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you're right. You got it.
To Lobaka.
How has it like been like 2 years now, 50 something episodes, and I'm still having trouble with the points here? Lobaka. Good job, Lobaka. That was a deep one. COVID brain. Yeah, thank you, Guy Cognito. Someone's
Kurgas? Somebody check,
give me a number. Kurgas?
Just submitted his 50 Cent and Alice DJ mix instead of a trailer. The comment.
That's cool.
Love you, bro. Follow me at Kurgas.
That's cool.
Take your shot, you know?
Yeah. Shoot your shot, bro.
Yeah.
Cause that's funny. Cause it's not like a robot spam. It's like he's actually watching the show and see how it works.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Ooh, R-rated trailer.
A storm is brewing, my friends. Someone has to stop it.
Every Sunday for about a year now, we've been inviting a guest over for dinner and discussion.
Zach, this is Mark.
Oh, hey.
Mark, this is Zach.
You're a bunch of damn liberals.
What are you, a Nazi?
Or is that too far to the left?
Hitler had the right idea.
Excuse me?
Well, that's where that comes from. People that say that on the internet from this movie.
Oh.
It's just, they're just quoting a movie.
It's this is
terrible. Just, yeah, it's a reference.
Whose death makes the world a better place.
Blue bottle is bad. The green bottle is good.
Everyone, this is Reverend Gerald Hutchins.
Homosexuality is the terrible disease, and AIDS is the cure.
When a woman cries rape, it's usually because she's already consented to sex.
Really?
Yeah, really.
I've never met anyone who's anti-Earth.
We're not even giving people a decent meal anymore.
The fag basher had Chinese.
Have you seen any of these men?
Ready for my wine?
All right.
Brother, have you lost your mind serving me this filthy swine?
How about toast?
I think we're in the clear. And would you take off those glasses and that homeboy hat? Shh, it's a secret.
A homeboy hat?
Fellas wouldn't know a guy could get a decent meal around here, would you?
Yes.
File this under amazing stories, my friends.
I remember that trailer.
Yeah. Oh, great. I genuinely think that looks like worth watching and still relevant. What year was that? 96?
Remake? Is that what we're talking about? A remake?
Somebody get Zach on the phone. I'm giving that 2 points. I thought it was great.
I'll also give that 2 points. I like the art at the end. I thought that was really fun.
Was it a pumpkin?
The like drawing thing that's like you don't see that much, and you really like got the point of the movie, you got the plot. It's fun. What are you guys doing? You know what sucks is I'm like kind of hungry. It's like the worst topic to do when you're kind of hungry.
I think Timmy picked this when he was hungry.
You know? Okay. Oh, wait. So was it? So what you're saying is he was awake.
Okay. So we're still. I mean, 2 minutes. We're still people voting. This has got a lot of positive. This is interesting because when we do the previous polling, we didn't get that much interaction, and now I'm seeing like 50 people have voted for this. You know,
I like. Usually we don't get this where a movie's just kind of like a charming movie.
Yeah.
And it's, and everyone's into it.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I feel like the relevancy of it is really interesting too, you know? Still plays. It fucking still plays, bro. Hey, Hendrowski, let's get down. Kate Van Dyke, resubscribe, let's get down. Panini Meanie, resubscribe, rock on, let's get down. Spinning Hook resubscribed as well. Oh, Thick Wings is dropping gift subs. I thought that was great. And interestingly enough, so that got 94%. So that's 3 points from chat. That's very positive for chat. I don't think chat is usually that overwhelmingly accepting of some of the trailers. So 4 points, 3 points, 7 points going to The Last Supper, which was submitted a bunch, but the one we chose by random happenstance is Fudgy Stuff. So Fudgy Stuff with 7 points. Congrats.
I almost put my, I almost messed up. Are you ready?
Yes. Wait. Yes. Ooh, Vidmark.
Did you ever make a wish? Did you ever have a dream?
Is this going to be a Gooby voiceover
Imagine
line?
Imagine having the magic to make your wishes come true.
Mom, will you buy me a tent for my birthday? Oh, by the way, I'm going to the mall after school with Aaron.
No, it's Anna not. Klumsky.
Now, guys, I love you to bits, but I'm sick and tired of this.
Is this a space trek?
If I'm going out in this house, it's not
yes,
clean.
Yes, this is a space trek.
Nobody is going out this weekend, and I mean it.
Don't you wish we had one of those muggles who did everything for you?
Now, with a little help from a magic friend.
Can you just do some magic to make people disappear?
They just might get what they want.
Wow! I feel good.
She's gone. We're free.
Is this the twin movie to, like, Mrs. Doubtfire?
Now that she's gone.
Or, like, Camp Nowhere.
Have just begun.
We want a new mother, not no mother.
And then you could go to the mommy market and pick out a new mother.
Welcome to the mommy market. We've got them all here.
Did they kill her mom?
Here's a mother who can teach you how to take care of yourself.
She's taken.
Should they choose one with lots of money?
Wow, we get to ride, miss.
Oh, surely you did not expect us to take the bus.
That?
He's my iguana.
Should they pick a mom who's full of energy?
She's awesome. She's everything we can want in a mother.
We are going camping today!
A skateboard mom.
I gotta go number two.
You leave.
Or how about a mom who's really fun?
Who would like to join circus?
Me.
What if they don't want to be in the circus?
What about the going tour?
We don't want to go in tour.
Hit the brakes!
Which one's the brake?
Let him go! I've got you now!
Hit!
I hate them all. I just wish we could find our own mother.
Why can't we remember her?
How can we get her back?
The only way.
Because she's dead.
Is remembering your mother.
For every kid who's ever wanted to trade in his mother, Academy Award winner Sissy Spacek and My Girl star Anna Klumsky in Trading Mom.
Wow, Trading Mom.
I wonder what happens at the end.
What do you mean? Do you just saw it.
Do you think they get the mother back?
We saw everything.
Yeah. First, they do this, then they do this, and then they feel sad, and then they want their mom back.
We got to see all the moms they tried out and the downfalls of all the moms. In a 3-minute trailer, if your whole movie can be boiled down in 3 minutes,
it's not good. Maybe it shouldn't be.
Museum of Home Video does this thing called Fasterpiece Theater, where they'll take like something that's like a bad movie and just cut out like the slow parts that you don't need to watch and leave in like like the weird parts. And so you can watch like a lot of these like movies you've heard of, but you really don't want to sit through to watch in about half an hour. It's great. Big fan of what they do over on Museum of Home Video. I liked the trailer. They did give too much away, but it's like it's a cute movie. I feel I give that a point.
I feel like I was gonna give it a point, and then they showed me the ending. I mean, it was. The thing that like really tickled me about it though was it was a whole movie about these kids wanting their mom dead.
And then they killed her.
And like
they cut that out of the trailer and it's like, yo.
Yeah. And you're not really like exploring it, you know?
Hmm. They're like, how do we get our mom back? And the old lady's like, I just buried her in the garden. Like she's dead. Yeah. Who do you think I am?
How do we get her mom back? What do you mean?
No kickbacks.
How do we get her back? Wait, you said you wanted to get rid of your mom, so I got rid of her.
I know you're only like 5 years old, but let me explain something about the world to you. The mom trading market doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Chad didn't like that. This is also funny because it gives like, it goes down to decimals. So it's like 75.5%
said no. Oh, whoa.
So it's not, it, we don't even have enough for 1 point in chat. Not
yeah, it's a zero point. Pointer from chat. Yeah. So that was, where was that? It was, what was that called?
Trading Mom.
Trading Moms. Trading Mom. That's it. Or the, so 1 point to Ryan Scott Atkins. I'm going to give it no point.
That was great. I'm sorry. I like that trailer.
You gave it 1 point.
Yeah. I gave it 1 point. I didn't think it was amazing, but I thought it was worth more than 1 point collectively. But you know what? To me personally, only give me 1 point. Chat, give me a number. Alien works at 25. In relation to something else, but it is a number, and it's a number I saw first. So, let me see. 25. Let's see this. All right. Ooh, Scream Horror Factory.
We know that you will be fulfilling your dream of helping those in need.
He's a football player? That's
a surprise from all of us who are lucky enough to call you friend.
For she's a young fellow, for she's a young
looks like a costume party.
Here's the skinny. We have got a variety of wacky activities on the docket for tonight.
Meow.
The stage has clearly been set for an old-school, pseudo-European, gangster-style slumber party.
Why pseudo?
Seriously, like we're not good enough for the real thing?
We're gonna eat you guys. The raw, the cooked, one at a time, until we are so stuffed we can barely move because we are. It's our tradition.
Every eve of every hour.
Tonight's not really about roughage.
I don't play these games. This is some sick white people only shit.
This is turning into a snooze fest. We've killed like two people. Let it rip, babe.
Oh! Game 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon. Winner gets to keep their legs.
Sean was in Stand By Me with Will Wheaton. Wheaton was in Hamboat and Hilly with Lillian Gish.
My God, tell her what she's won.
Sarah
when
Silverman.
You were born, what name were you given?
Anson?
Anson, like Manson.
It totally rhymed.
And Sarah Silverman in this one scene that we fit her in.
Yeah.
That actor, the guy who's like one of the murder guys that wasn't Jimmy Simpson, he was in like the best episode of 6 Feet Under when like I think the brother's name is David, gets like kidnapped. Remember that episode? Yeah. That's the guy.
Yeah.
Good actor. I don't know if I like that one.
You know what really like got me?
What?
Not in a good way. Someone cheese gratering someone's face.
Yeah.
Cause it's so dull, you know?
Yeah. You know what's always funny to me though is like some of these movies where they're like when they're like, we're gonna eat people, not like, you know, savage, you know, cannibals, we're gonna like cook you and eat you. They're always like covered in blood. Nobody's like doing it like, you know, yeah, like a butcher cleaning up and then cooking and eating, you know, like they're doing it like
so. Yeah, no one's been sanitary.
Yeah, yeah, what exactly
that, what is that shirt that you're wash wearing up?
Who, me?
Yeah. Oh, I thought it was like, I was like, the lightning bolt made it look like it was like almost like vinyl-y. I thought it was like reflecting.
Oh, yeah. This is another one of those Rucking Foughton shirts, you know? This was a Godzilla one they did.
Cool.
Yeah, I liked it.
Yeah, all right.
Could use some overalls.
Yeah, could use some overalls. Yeah.
I'm not going to give that a point.
I'm not going to give it a point either. That they lost me with the cheese grater to the face. Directed by James Rhode from Psych. Written and directed by James Rhode from Psych.
I'm having a hard time believing, like, based on the trailer alone, that there's more to this movie besides, like, hey, we kill and eat people every Halloween, and then it's, like, a trailer of them doing all this, like, gory graphic stuff, you know? I feel like there should be something else, right?
Yeah. It seems like a very, like Final Girl situation.
Yeah. Actually, you mean Final Girl the movie or Final Girl the concept?
Concept.
Yeah. Dan Ballard, I don't know who that is. All right, so chat gave that 53% no, so that's 1 point from chat. And that 1 point, you didn't give it points, right?
No.
Guy Incognito, you get 1 point. You blew all your good stuff last season.
All right, you ready?
Yep. Oh, yeah, we have to get a clip of Sam yelling overalls.
And the director of Psycho 3 put their heads together. There's only one way to describe the results. A comedy.
If anyone here has reason why these two should not be joined,
me!
I don't think she understood the question.
Yes, I did.
About a big guy.
Not with anyone.
Whale.
I have no one.
And a beautiful girl.
I think people are good.
I told you she was perfect.
And when she brought him home for the holidays.
Don't waste any meat. Not now.
What if your parents don't like me?
Is it Joe DeRosa?
They made him feel like one of the family.
Your hand's freezing. Better get some clothes before it falls off.
But there was something strange about them.
I'd like you to meet our guests for Christmas Day.
Will he discover their secret?
We love people. We know how good they really are.
Before supper time.
How does dinner look?
You look delicious.
I'm not a guest. I'm the buffet.
Lucky Stiff.
Nothing a cold shower and a rub down with steel wool wouldn't cure.
I kind of like that.
I did too. You know what I liked about this? What? Is like I liked it as a trailer. I would hate to watch that movie. That guy was annoying. that guy, you're like, oh, it almost in the same way of Last Supper, you're like, oh, I get why they're gonna eat this guy. I guess Last Supper they're just killing them, but like
I feel like the opposite though. I mean, obviously like a full movie would get annoying, but like I liked him in the trailer, you know, like, oh, I'm cracking jokes and shit, you know, like it's funny.
Yeah, yeah. No, but I mean, like, I feel like that watching a whole movie of that guy is going to be, would be so annoying.
Yeah. I do want to hit the early part too. Hold on. Are you saying?
Oh, yeah. What did they say in the beginning?
He was getting married.
Police Academy. And the director of Psycho 3 put their heads together. There's only one way to describe the results. A comedy.
If anyone here has reason why these two should not be joined.
Me!
I don't think she understood the question.
Yes, I did.
A big guy.
Not with anyone who's alive.
No one?
I have no one.
And a beautiful girl.
It's just funny, that whole scene of like the wife, the fiance being like,
yeah,
I object to my own wedding, you know?
Yeah.
Okay, so chat is 80% no. Oh, chat.
Strong Egg says, dude, I love Jonah Hill.
Mm-hmm.
A zing.
Yeah, anything where you step on a rake, my classic gag, classic, I love it. All right, poll's over, guys. That was over 80%. That's 0 points right from chat. Strong no from chat. I'm gonna give it a point.
I'll give it a point too.
We're men of culture, Sam and I.
Where was it? Lucky Stiff by from Jay Nihilist.
Denialist.
I'm gonna you get two. Never heard points.
Of it. Never heard of it. Somebody give me a number. You got hit in the dick by all the flags. Yeah, it's like, hey, why don't you stop skiing? Turn to the side. You know? Oh, whatever. I feel that movie is probably so filled with like physical gags that I'm in. You know, like I think that shit's so good. Okay.
You're sitting at home and your stomach is bubbling. No food in the fridge and your hunger is growing. You hop in your car and head straight to get drive-through. Murder with fries is described as fast food. To be baked and broiled,
thrown in a pan to be fried in some oil.
This is the Offspring.
I love that it has a song. We have a challenge for this.
Don't kill little baby chickens.
This is a long one. Whoa. So we got a challenge on that.
Oh, you got Sam, a challenge graphic, huh?
Yeah, so we got a couple challenge graphics. We have not yet done a challenge in season four yet, and I know the rules have changed, so why don't you go over the rules? Do we vote on that one, or do we watch the other one and then vote? What do we do?
Here comes the challenger!
What have we been doing? I'm tired.
Here comes the challenger!
I don't know, man. It's your show. Like, I think previously...
Here comes the challenger!
Previously, we have...
voted on that and waited till the challenge, till the person challenged.
Here's the thing. Like, if people hated that, but the challenge one is dope, then the person who challenges win the challenge, but they don't get the points.
Here comes the challenger!
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, I think you're right. How do you want to do it?
I don't know. Should we watch the other one and then vote which one's better?
Sure. Okay.
Okay. All right. Sith Psychopath. Will you find that one in the list?
Okay, here we go.
Start off. Oh God, the trailer hasn't even started yet.
It's 3 minutes. 3 minutes and 15 seconds long. Okay.
You the manager?
You know it.
Give me a job. I'm a high school graduate, just trying to make his way in this topsy turvy world. My life, it sucks. And my one true love?
I'll stay true to you. It'll never change me. I promise.
Is a left-wing lipstick lesbo liberal. Ah, Wendy!
Arby?
You said you'd never change, but here you are, you're just bumping tacos.
You're hired.
What do I do?
You're the counter girl.
Oh, this is fucking filled up ancient Tomahawk tribe, sacred Indian burial ground. Get out while you still can. Get out. Save yourselves. Save yourselves.
I'll have the Sloppy Jose value meal.
Good morning, Traumaville!
We will never rest while big business tramples over the rich history and culture of the Native Americans while simultaneously slaughtering countless innocent chickens.
Hey, General, what are these tiny little bumps all over my chicken?
Those are our new flavor pods.
Ooh, flavor pods.
Look at the atrocities American Chicken Bunker performs on the chickens that you serve to the ignorant masses.
We produce only high-quality chicken-flavored foodstuffs.
And now, the most important part, the secret zest sauce.
Every leg, every thigh is fresh, tasty, and oh my God, my ass!
They are very slowly
approaching the entrance.
They'll break through faster than the 5 minutes it took me to turn Wendy into a full-blown lesbian.
Damn it. We need action before they turn the glass into lesbians.
The chicken has declared jihad on us all.
Hit the button.
Problematic.
Okay, so we have two trailers. Okay, we have the music trailer, and then we have the one with all the dialogue.
All right, All right, wait. Stop the poll.
I haven't started the poll. Yeah.
Oh, well, all right. So here's what we'll do is the music trailer's number one. The last trailer, the talky one, is number two. Okay. Vote which one you like best.
Better. Better. Poultry. There's no way. Autocorrect is like, what are you trying to say? Poultrygeist?
I mean, just throw up a poll. Like, it could be yes and no.
The music first one or trailer, the dialogue one?
Yeah, sure.
All right. It's up now. It's up now, guys. You got to choose either one. You got to choose one or the other. There is no three. It's either you like the one better with the music. The thing is with the music one, they're both long. The music one, it was like, it was funny that there was a song. And then in the dialogue one, you really got more of the movie. It's funny that Troma's been doing movies as long as they have, and that's the trailer they put out, you know? It's like, make a shorter trailer. People who want to see Troma movies are going to see the Troma movies. You don't have to try so hard.
Seems like a bad company.
I feel like if you are a Troma person, right, you work for Troma or whatever, and you're trying to get people that don't already know about you to watch your movies, having like a nearly 4 minute trailer where you explain the entire movie, probably not the best way to do it. I don't know. I'm not in marketing.
Yeah. Okay.
What do you personally think, Sam? Which one of those two did you like?
Both of them were way too long.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were both really bad. I don't know.
Well, it looks like the dialogue won, the challenger won.
Okay, dialogue 1-1. All right, now we have to vote for that trailer. Okay. So here's just the vote for it. And I'm going to give it a 0. Lloyd Kaufman is actually in the first GOTG. Don't know about the second. GOTG, what's...
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Game of the Gones.
People do not like this movie. It is the challenge is was it a Pyrrhic victory in that challenge, apparently. All of that. This psychopath. Wait, this psychopath voted 1 for his own trailer?
It's creeping up. It's creeping up. I think it might get a point.
This psychopath. Was that... Wait, did I get that wrong? Did Sith Psychopath not challenge that? Or was it a different challenger?
No, that was Sith Psychopath.
Sith Psychopath, you gave your own trailer a no. That's great. That's great. Grimward, we should not have a trauma theme.
Yeah, no.
Sith Psychopath says, I mean, I have to be honest, for the show's integrity, I just wanted to win. All right, so you did win. You did win, but your victory is Pyrrhic. I am ending now. That's a 75.5%.
That's zero.
That's 0 points from chat. 0 points from Sam. I'm going to give it 1 point because I feel the effort you put into it and brought it to our attention. You know, it's now that I know I've seen that, it's in my head forever and I can avoid it. So 1 point to Sith Psychopath. And I need another number for chat.
That was your trailer.
That was my trailer.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. All right. So Dan Ballard was the original challenger. Did you give Sith Psychopath the point?
Oh, no.
Because I didn't see where that was.
Dan, better luck next time. Good guy, Dan Ballard.
You know him?
He took my class.
Oh. All right. Don't give me numbers. It's Sam's choice. Sam. Do you remember what number the Sith Psychopath one was?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, there we go. You. Sam's turn.
Here's the thing. I had one picked out, but then you made me go
pick this out. So that's why, if you have someone you pick out,
here.
Just to the right of it, you can put S for Sam, hit enter, and it highlights in green for you.
I don't like doing that.
All right,
because the color's too dark and it makes me think that like it's like
cross. You can do it just for the one, the next one.
Problematic.
Strange things been happening around here.
Reverend, I can explain everything.
Is that Mark Rylance?
Are you?
We're from Copperton. The town's been taken over by this fanatical reverend who's leading a group of saints.
I don't understand how some people
just kill my daughter, you stupid son of a bitch.
Balance the music a bit?
I'm not sure.
The new order shall emerge and the feeble non-believers shall bleed.
There's nothing you can do.
Nobody move.
I've got the proof that you are one sick bastard.
My God does have mercy, but I don't.
They must be integrated.
Wouldn't you want to be one of us? Control your own destiny? Dominate others? See your dreams and fantasies come to life before your very eyes?
I've got to go.
I want this.
Very nice, Mary.
That ending part was really funny. I don't know how it fits the theme, though.
He's at a diner in one part, but yeah, I think you're right. What was that called again? Heartland of Darkness. A cummy attraction for Timmy. Lost Linnaeus. Oh, is that? Wait, maybe I screwed this up.
Okay.
A cummy attraction. What are the cummy attractions?
That's the when we watch a movie, a preview trailer at the top of the show.
No, a cummy attraction.
Oh, that's just Timmy's like reissue DVDs.
Oh, okay.
So I don't think this is an official submission.
Let's not vote for this. Here, I'll just pick this other one.
I loved that, though. I thought that looked dope as fuck.
All right.
I got it, Flanger. I mean, I thought that was cool as shit, man. Timmy should know about this if he's not watching now. Should we call Timmy? Tell him he missed some shit?
No.
I'm already dialing. It's too late now.
All right, well, I got another trailer lined up.
Hold on. I just want to see if Timmy's heard of this movie.
Hello.
You do the Timmy voice.
Hey, man.
Hey, what's up, Timmy?
Hi, this is Timmy Williams. I
can't. Funny. Wouldn't it be funny if he did, like, hey, this is Timmy Williams. My phone number is. Like an old person. Okay. All right. If you're ready, I'm ready.
All right.
No, Timmy's playing football. I don't know if you guys know this, but he got really into football. He's Jock Timmy now.
Leon, look at their necks.
Here we go again.
Your necks are bigger than your heads.
Mara, it's only because there are no muscles in our heads to exercise.
The Barbarian Brothers.
Yes!
Yo, nice hit. Is that a supercut?
They're big.
Indubitably. Indubitably.
Bold.
Hey, Junior, maybe you should lay off the growth hormone.
Why?
And fast with their fists.
Well, excuse my brother, he needs electrocution lessons.
But when they come between the mob and the feds...
The boy's really done his job on those hoods.
They come.
I'd like you to stay here and look after my nephews.
Who's a hat?
It's the start of a whole new career.
Yo, we're the babysitters.
Twin sitters.
What are they anyway? They're like some kind of cloning experiment that went horribly wrong.
They thought that no one could face them down.
Relax, man. They're just little kids.
Little monsters more like it.
No!
But this time, they've met their match.
All we've got to do to win them over is show them that they can trust us.
Yeah, how do we do that?
Oh, boys, say hello to your Uncle Frank.
Yeah, look at that midriff shirt.
You don't want to take a bath.
Like the bamboo.
Let's go.
What is this these guys' closet look like?
Jacob!
Looks like the prop closet at an improv theater.
It looks like the Lost Boys from Hook's closet.
Yeah, everybody fast.
Dressed like Rufio. Today,
Captain's head.
Sitters.
Man, even a blouse.
It's also funny that the kids are like twins. The kids are twins. And they're like, these guys are a genetic experiment gone awfully wrong. Like,
yeah. It's like, you guys are also twins. I fucking loved that, bro. Loved that. That's a 2 points way up because they're twins.
2 points up.
Double dragons.
That's a bonus point there.
Did you see it? Did it not work?
Yeah, it worked.
I'm going to put the thing on this side because I have to reach over here and do this. That's fun. That's 5 points from us. I fucking geeked out. I'm like, also, I just want to flash back to like where the still frame is on this. Look at the shirt that he's wearing that I was pulling out, like off the shoulder, off both shoulders, right? Cut in the middle, full on, like just covering his nipples here. How uncomfortable do you think that is to wear? Because if you put your arms any lower down your side, it's just falling right down you. Like, this is ridiculous. Yeah. What was the dinner about this? In the very beginning, there was they were having family dinner. The whole beginning part.
It's only because there are no muscles in our heads.
See?
There's the dinner part for you. Spaghetti. They also dump spaghetti on the kids, too.
You only need one scene with dinner? Apparently so.
Yeah.
Apparently so. It was enough.
I mean, were you looking for trailers and going... There's not enough dinner scenes.
It's not about dinner. I don't know if I can vote for this. They have dinner in the movie. It doesn't have to be movies about dinner.
Yeah, it clearly checks the box.
Yeah. And, you know, I don't think chat was really following us on that because they only gave it 2 points. They only gave it 59%.
All right, so that's a 7-point trailer.
7-point trailer. Who gets it?
That's to Flangia. Felt bad about the whole heart to Heartland to Darkness thing. Not really understanding his comment, and
that's how to do it.
Felt like
chat. That's how to do it. You know what? The funny thing is, chat wasn't there with us on that, but like, damn, that was great Trailer Boys stuff. All right, I need another number. Lydia Petunia says, I take this very, very seriously. Not enough dinner. No point. Also, Lydia Petunia only started watching Trailer Boys like 4 episodes ago.
Yeah. What a fucking poser.
Poser. 34. Okay. Okay. Look at the context for this one, Sam. Oh, that's funny.
All right, should we read the context and then show the trailer?
Yeah. The context for this is some old hag cooks up some tasty food. I gave it away right away.
Food itself is like a passport.
Let her rip!
You look lovely this morning.
Not camera ready, as they say.
What are you going to talk about?
I guess the book. Before everyone forgets about it completely.
At this stage of my life, I want to feel relevant.
Have you seen this?
My guest this afternoon writes cookbooks.
Great. I really like
we'll rename our little program What My Wife's
like,
Been Reading.
It's all like WBZ,
welcome,
right?
Julia Child.
Yeah, it's Julia
Cameron. What a lovely introduction. I've come just in time.
Ooh. What is she doing?
Are you all right down there?
You were a treasured guest in living rooms all over Boston.
To Julia.
To us.
I've had a recurring thought that I'd like to propose to you. An educational cooking show hosted by myself.
Feels flimsy to me. This is public television, for God's sake.
Shouldn't it's the guy from
the more camera-friendly
Cabin in the Woods.
Cabin in the Woods.
You were onto something so big. I'm just sorry that my colleagues don't have the vision to see it yet.
Where are these gentlemen? One of the advantages of looking like me is that you learn at a young age how not to take no for an answer. I don't know if I can do all this.
Doing this is genius.
Action.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me.
Is that BB Newworth?
Welcome to the French Chef.
Yeah.
The BBC is making docs about prize-winning scientists.
So BB Newworth is in it? And?
Yeah. Every critic, silence every artist. How dull would the world be then?
Now,
Niles.
Butchering a chicken.
Niles.
Nothing to be afraid
yes,
of.
Niles
the
and,
legs, the wings, the thighs, bullets. And... the breath.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
I envision a confederacy of women and estrogen safety net.
Well, I like the sound of that.
I don't think this is a TV show. I think it's a movie.
Oh, you're not afraid of a little flame, are you?
No, it is a TV show.
It is a TV show.
It is a TV show.
I suppose I'll have to get used to sharing you. Everyone wants you. You ain't left the ground.
My advice, enjoy the ride. Wait
till why do you call it the French Chef? You're not French. Wait
till I she mugs like she's Lucille Ball.
Be a lady.
I am a lady, Dad, just not your type. Let her in.
Best is yet to come, come the
it's
day.
A miniseries. Yes. Yeah, it's a miniseries.
I hope you had as much
eyes,
fun as I did.
Bon appétit.
The best is yet to come, come
no.
The day of my...
Hey, we don't count that? All right. That was Micromegas. Sorry, Micromegas. No. No vote. I do suggest chat to check that out. It's great. It's a good one. She comes. Okay. Sorry, guys. I didn't know. I've seen it. I didn't know. Maybe I've only seen one episode.
Are you ready?
Well, I get to go again.
Okay.
Okay.
Do a Peacemaker. About the flight attendant. Do the flight attendant.
No, no, I'm on these three right here. 54.
This. The Staircase. There's dinner in the miniseries The Staircase.
Okay. Wait, this might be a TV series too. If you look at this one, it's a Hulu original.
I was looking at that.
Actually, I'm just gonna do this one. This one's definitely a movie.
I just want you all to know how much it means to us that you're all here.
Thanks to Mom and Dad.
Beautiful.
Just a perfect day.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank thee for thy food and help us to do our part with kind words and loving deeds.
Amen.
Amen. It gets dark, we go home.
What is that?
Get away from the window!
What is happening?
I don't see anyone.
Why would anybody do this? They've been watching us for days. Wasn't a random attack.
Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you. Oh, such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. You just keep me.
When I watched this, I was surprised it was not like a bigger movie, and I feel like it should be a bigger movie. The dad did it.
Is that the spoiler?
No, and it's not a spoiler. I mean, the dad is the one killing everybody at the end.
Oh well, I you know told you I haven't seen the movie. You asked me, and I said I hadn't. And then you told me the ending.
That's not a spoiler.
Well, you spoiled the ending.
It's not a spoiler because it's a lie.
Now I don't. I know that Dad didn't do it.
Well, the dad's on. There's no dad watching the whole time. Like, when does the dad show up? You ever done that where you like start watching a movie that you think you know what it is, and you're like waiting, and you're like, "Oh, I've heard about this movie." It, like this thing happens, and the whole time, like I went and saw Chuck and Buck in the movie theater.
That's what you're gonna say.
Have I told the story on stream before?
I don't. You've told it to me before.
I saw Chuck and Buck in the theater, and if you guys have seen it, it's like Mike White and the whole thing. It's like Mike White and his childhood friend, and the childhood friend comes back for Mike White's mother's funeral, and then like you find out like when they were kids, they would like suck each other off. Or it was very odd. I don't really know what the rest of the movie is, but it's kind of about this one dude being weird. And so I thought it was like this Australian really comedy. I was just the whole time like, was like, what movie are we actually watching? Because I was like, I thought it was like these two Australian teenagers named Chuck and Buck, like going wild or something. So,
You should go back and watch it. It's really funny. Mike White's
just spoiled
great.
Chuck and Buck. Polls over. Chat gave that 3 points. I'm going to give it 1 point. I like the movie and I like the song in the trailer, but the trailer also seemed kind of boring. It seemed very like, oh, one of those type of movies, you know?
Quick thing about Chuck and Buck. The theater that Chuck and Buck, or that Chuck puts a play on in Chuck and Buck, it's the same theater that I started a comedy theater at.
Oh, interesting. Mythic says, Nate's always accidentally getting gay stuff. Yeah, GP. I'm accidentally watching GP.
I heard a thing about Chuck and Buck this week, which was really funny, which was apparently Mike White saw Goodwill Hunting, and he hated it, and he hated it so bad because it's about these like handsome guys, and it's about this like how this handsome guy who's a genius just needs to do as much as he can. And he was like, this handsome, charming guy who's a genius. This guy has everything. And it's like, oh, you just have to do something, Will. And apparently he was like, I want to make a movie where the main character makes people feel like they have spiders on their skin.
Yeah, that's pretty funny. What do you give your next?
I'll give it 1 point. I liked it's pretty standard, but the music is good.
Yeah, that was great. And I feel like normally, that would be enough for me to be like 2 points. But as I've seen the movie, I think it's tainted my view a little bit because it's like, it's a great movie. The trailer doesn't give a lot away, but it also doesn't give me enough to make it, you know, stand out from other shit that does that, you know? Like, if you showed me that trailer in Funny Games, similar, I'd be like, Funny Games.
Yeah. Drained. Should we do two more?
Sure. So that was your next. So that was 2 points from us, 3 points from chat, 5 points total to Rocky Horror Pepsi Blow. There you go. That seems like a new name to the list. Rocky Horror Pepsi Blow. Pepsi Blow. There you go.
That's really funny. Rocky Horror Pepsi Blow.
Yeah.
All right. Ready?
Yep.
Coming soon, Randy Quaid, Mary Beth Hurt, Sandy Dennis, and director Bob Balaban bring you a fresh look at family life.
Bob Balaban.
The Lemley family is moving up in the world.
Rise and shine!
But something is eating at young Michael Lemley.
You're not scared of your room, are you? Michael, the cellar's dark. Everything's dark at night.
His parents think Michael's problem is in his head. But Michael knows it's on his plate.
What are we eating? Leftovers, honey.
Leftovers from what?
From the refrigerator.
We have leftovers every day since we moved here. I'd like to know what they were before they were leftovers.
Before that, they were leftovers to be.
There's a new name for terror. Parents.
Bedtime.
I love that. That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Going for it.
Great. Always
live. Always live. Yeah.
The parents title card is like really cool. Funny, kind of cool style. The shot with the blood in the refrigerator was cool. I dig it.
Yeah, I'm gonna give that 2 points. Short and
I'm
sweet.
I'm also going to give it to you.
It had like a weird vibe to it, you know? There was like a weird bend. Like even when he was doing this, when he was touching his head, like, you know, it's in your head. The way he did it was so oddly unsettling because he would normally be like, you know, just he did it in such an odd way that it bugged me out. So I like that in movies where like somebody will do something that you see or say, you know, 100 times. So it's not a thing. And they do it so just slightly different that it really like changes the character, you know?
All right. So you give it 2 points?
I give it 2 points.
I give it 2 points.
Chat seems very overwhelmingly yes on that. It's 86% climbing. So it's 3 points for chat. Who gets those 3 points, Samwise?
3 points. That's going to the beach that makes you old.
Old.
So it says a big old 7 for the beach that makes you old.
Okay, chat, give me a number. Shitter's full. 76, 63.
They call it Hamburger Helper, but it tastes just fine by itself.
That's funny. 76 was parents. Let's see. Somebody keeps saying 2. We've already done 2. Okay. Parents could submit it a bunch. Okay. Trailer starts now.
It was always just my mom and me. To have a family, that's what I really want.
She was in
no way. I got a cousin.
That is the whitest thing I've ever seen.
He wants to meet up. Oliver?
Cousin Evie.
It sounds so Jane Austen when you say it like that. You know, my mom always wanted to take me to England to learn about our family history.
There's a wedding coming up, actually. You should come.
I would love to, but I...
Come on, everyone is dying to meet you.
Wow, it's incredible.
I believe this is one of our important guests.
Evie, this is a close friend of the family, Walter DeVille.
Hi.
Hi. Looking forward to getting to know you better, Evie.
That's her American accent.
What are you doing down there?
Miss, you should return to your room.
We're all so delighted that you're here.
Which one's the groom?
The groom and his bride will make their grand entrance tomorrow.
Ready?
I can't shake the feeling that everyone is staring at me.
Can you blame them?
You and Walter seem to be getting awfully close, Evie. I'm curious, though. What has he told you about us?
Ow! Let me see.
There she is.
Where are the bride and groom?
As you all know, there has been someone missing from this table.
But that once broken bond will be renewed tonight.
To Evie,
my new bride.
I want to go home.
But this is your home.
Get her prepared.
There are children in us. Children of our sick.
Help me, please.
Yeah, dear.
Hello, Mr. Harker here. There's a young lady who seems quite distressed.
I'm so glad you've come to your senses, my love.
I didn't know this movie's already out. I thought that looked really cool. I liked because it seemed a little bit different where all these other movies, very similar, like, oh, you're coming to dinner, and guess what? You are dinner. This seemed a little different where it's like they want her to also partake in said dinner.
Yeah.
Didn't do it for you?
Didn't do it for me.
Huh. Well, the poll's up now. We'll see what chat feels about it. Yeah, I mean, I a lot of these, again, like, are very, very similar. It kind of seemed like, is it Ready or Not? A little Ready or Not-ish.
Oh, yeah. I always get Ready or Not confused with You're Next.
See, that's the thing, is it's very easy to, like, get them all mixed up. I do want to see that. That seems worth watching to me. Ready or Not, but Not Funny. Yeah. Ready or Not supposed to be silly, though, I think, right?
Yeah.
Wow, says Psychopath, posting links in the chat. Tisk, tisk. They're all made by the same people. Is that true? Same writer, director, or same like production house? Oh, interesting. Thick and Wing has been confirming when the poll is up because the lag makes a difference. Good call. Wonder what the lag is like.
Oh, because they only see the poll on Strom.
Nate.chat, the website for Nate chatting. Get it.
Let's see. Okay.
Are you on Mastodon, Sam?
No.
Oh.
Are you on Mastodon?
Yeah.
I'm
on the,
cool?
On the Rave node. It's like everything else. It's like a decentralized Twitter. Pretty funny.
Seems like a good idea.
Yeah, I was like, oh, I wasn't really on Twitter anyway. So it's like I got on it like, oh, it's new, and it's like, oh yeah, they can't take it down. It's decentralized. It's, you know, you're on these nodes that are hosted by people. I was like, cool. And then I'm like reading all the stuff, and all of it is about like Twitter. Like, and Mastodon, and I'm like, I don't care. I didn't care before.
Okay.
It's still not in the mode where subscribers get double. Yeah, no. Subscribers, that was only on my channel that subscribers get double points. All right, so I'm going to end the poll, and it looked like only 33% said yes, so that's 1 point. I am going to give it 2 points. That's 3 points.
And I'm going to give it no points.
Wow, not any points from Sam. That is crazy. So 0 points from Sam. I feel it's worth a point. That is Niamix. That's the invitation from Niamix. Thank you. It's still not. Oh, there we go. All right, Sam. This is Sam's last trailer.
It's my last trailer.
Is this what I ordered?
Yes, that is the risotto. Oh. It's a special recipe that my brother and I bring from Italy.
But I get a side order of spaghetti with this, right?
Why? She likes starch. I don't know. Come on.
There are no meatballs with the spaghetti.
They were two brothers who came to America bearing Italy's greatest gift.
To eat good food is to be close to God. I'm never sure what that means, but it's true anyway.
They have a talent for cooking.
No, wait. Cut. Table.
Now, all they need...
If you give people time, they learn. This is a restaurant. Not a cooking school.
Is a recipe for success.
If we don't receive your payment by the end of the month, we will foreclose.
What do you mean?
Their only hope is a plan.
Louis?
But Italy's greatest gift was racism.
I make a call. He's in town next week. You cook for him.
Louis Prima is coming. He's not just some guy. He's famous.
Their only obstacle...
Men. Boys.
...is each other.
My brother
sometimes is too...
I have a younger brother. I hate his guts.
Their only chance...
How much does that leave?
$62.47.
...is a feast.
Say for Masha!
The Samuel Goldwyn Company and Reicher Entertainment invite you to the 4-star party of the year. Come on! A sumptuously satisfying movie from first course to last.
Oh my God.
It's good, huh? He likes.
It's Shalhoub.
You'll find the atmosphere is delicious.
Yeah, it's Shalhoub.
An appetite-rousing delight.
He's a party.
That's,
he's a party. Like
the service impeccably crafted, wonderfully accented,
two first things.
And every course a labor of love, delectable, warm, funny, and poignant.
What's his name? Who's in singles?
Yes, tonight.
It's about a dime.
We guarantee you a night you'll never forget.
Bite your teeth into the ass of life.
Big night.
Is that the guy who played Ash from waiting. Alien?
Let's see.
Your table is waiting.
Let's see.
Stanley Tucci co-produced it. Campbell Scott.
Oh, yeah.
Interesting.
He's got that. That's it. Is he's
Ian
got
Holm?
A last name for a first name and a first name for a last name.
Panini Media. It was Ian Holm that he played Ash. He was the first synthetic in Alien. Yeah, Panini Meanie, I got it right.
Do you know what I love that he does in Alien?
What?
Do you remember that part?
No. What was that
part? No, he's like, there's a part where when everyone's going out, they kind of like, I think it kind of alludes to him being an alien where he kind of like runs in place for a second. And to like psych himself up for some reason. Yeah.
All right. The poll is live for Big Night. Oh, yeah. He was Napoleon in Time Bandits. Yep. We did see that the other night. We watched Time Bandits the other night, and it's still good. The funny thing is, I got like a 90% in Rotten Tomatoes. It's fine. That was another movie that like my memory of it was better, you know. It didn't feel very sci-fi-ish after we ended, you know. I don't know. I gotta start, you know, we're coming to the end of the month. I think for Thanksgiving, I'll probably do a lot more watch parties. Because if you know, I'm not really gonna be doing a lot. So we're gonna crank out some of these hard science fiction movies.
Cool.
I do want to do a double feature, but I'm not sure what a good double feature would be. Like both Blade Runners back to back.
That could be fun.
David Warner is great. Has David Warner done any more sci-fi movies? I love watching David Warner. I like appreciating like, actors that, you know, they're great actors, but they're not like lauded as like, you know, these household names. David Warner from The Omen, Tron.
Oh yeah.
Seconding Dune. All right. All right. Want to finish a poll? And that looks like Big Night got 35% yes. I'm gonna give Big Night 0 points. Too many Italian stuffs. It was too Italian for
tricky.
Me.
Tricky.
What do you think, Sam?
No,
I don't know. Just
one point.
It didn't look interesting to me. It was like two brothers on a restaurant. And I'm like, I don't understand the two brothers. How come they're not best friends? Like, isn't that how it works for everybody?
It's the thing is with brothers, there's usually one brother with integrity and one brother who's like a sleazy money grubbing guy who's losing his hair.
Wow. Shots fired. Can you get wows in chat? Jerk. I didn't know you were losing your hair.
Oh.
Okay. Last movie of the night.
Yeah, last trailer of the night.
You ready?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Do you see this? This is all right, hold on. This is apparently, never mind. I thought this was the original. I think it's a sequel. Cigarettes! Every hair the baby grows, Sam loses.
Thanksgiving 2 has been destroyed. Only one copy remains, and Turkey will stop at nothing to get it.
Trailer made this song popular.
This is kind of like a ripoff of a 28 Days Later song.
Yep, that's what this
song is. Shall not pick!
Thanksgiving 3. What'd you think? Have you ever seen any Thanksgivings?
No, I have not. Have you?
No.
Is it comes like a, says it's the sexiest puppet movie ever made. Or ever.
Is it the new... is it a New Moon movie? Is it like one of those production places?
Seems like a really inventive.
We need points who won on Big Night. Sorry. I didn't choose Big Night. That was Sam.
Oh, wait. Oh, sorry.
Voting is open for Thanksgiving 3.
Let me see. Big Night. That was 1 point from chat, correct?
Yeah.
That was. Schwingles. That's 1 point for me.
Of course, every Schwingles would be the one that's like, we didn't know we didn't get points. You call it Schwingles. Yeah, look out for yourself.
Oh, we already gave Schwingles a point. Oh, we took a point away. He's at a net zero.
But didn't you give Big Night points too? Wouldn't it be like a net positive?
Oh, yeah, it's a net positive. Yeah, that's right. Okay. I give Thanksgiving 3 a 1. What do you give it?
I did think it's funny how like it's very self-referential because I don't think there is a Thanksgiving 2, right? It went from like 1 to 3. And that's like the joke. I don't know. I think maybe I would have appreciated Thanksgiving 1 more. So I'm only going to give it a point.
Okay.
What do you plan on watching this week, Sam? I just started getting into the Let the Right One In television series, and it seems pretty dope.
Oh, really?
I heard the Interview with the Vampire televised series is very good, too.
It seems trashy.
Well, it's Anne Rice.
Yeah.
True to the source material.
All right. So we have...
Thanks, Killian Gunn.
We have...
Sorry. 1 point, Sam.
Oh, no, you go for it. You go for it.
Well, it looks like it's getting 1 point. I'm giving Thanksgiving 1 point. You said how many?
One.
You gave it one. That's 2 from us, 1 from chat, 3 points for Thanksgiving. And that was submitted by a bunch of people, but this one was the theorists. 3 points from the theorists. Theorists.
Okay, we got 4 7-pointers and a 6-pointer. Okay. I don't know if we just want to stick to the 7-pointers or what.
Well, the interesting thing with this new poll system is there's no limit, so we can do whatever you want. So.
Okay. Well, why don't we just stick with the 7-pointers?
All right. Read them out to me.
Ravenous. Parents. Twin sitters. And the Last Supper.
Okay. Poll's up now. Poll is live, and it's going to be up a little longer than anything else. I'd say of those, the Ravenous trailer tickled me the most, how weird it was. So I'm going to give that points. Parents was also like pretty weird, but it was kind of like standard. Twin Sitters was super bizarro. Loved it. Last Supper seems like the best movie of the four, being like, what do I want to watch as a movie? It would probably be Last Supper. So for me, it's kind of a draw between Twin Sitters and Ravenous, and I think I will land on Twin Sitters as my favorite, but the Ravenous one, you know, remember how weird it was with the music and the voiceover.
You know what's interesting is I don't think I've seen a final poll be this close between all options. I could see any of these winning.
Yeah. They are pretty close. I think, you know, having it easier for chat to vote on, you know, changes it up too. Yeah. There's a lot more. We've been getting a lot more chat interaction. There's 196 people watching. Only 42 people have voted. So if you're watching from home, or you're listening while you're studying, or you're driving a truck, you could pull over, pull up chat. You have time to punch in 1 for Ravenous, 2 for Parents, 3 for Twin Sitters, or 4 for Last Supper. While the vote continues, Sam, I don't know what your plans are next week, but possibly next Sunday, I think. You know, you think of the Lydia Petunia says, "As Ravenous wins, it'd be a great reason for next team to be pilgrims." How many pilgrim movies can you think of? Which? Name all of them. But what do you think of a theme? What are you feeling?
I was thinking. All right, I had a couple ideas. One was movies with snow that aren't Christmas movies.
Okay.
I was thinking movies about shopping, oh, we gotta buy this thing, or like maybe it's like shopping mall. You know, Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
Where's the shopping in Fast Times at Ridgemont High?
They hang out at the mall.
Oh, yeah. Well, they work at the mall, right?
Yeah, they all work at the mall. And they
I always thought that was concept. Odd in that where like the restaurant was like right in the mall, you know?
Yeah.
And then, like, the movie theater was, like, right in the mall.
But I was thinking about shopping because of...
Black Friday,
yeah.
Cyber Sunday. Black Friday, Super Sale Saturday, Sexy Trailer Boy Sunday, Cyber Monday, Shopping Local Tuesday. I don't know what the other one is.
Yeah, retail movies. Yeah, is that a good one? There's a bunch that come to mind when I think of this.
All right, yeah. Don't burn them, because I feel like a lot of times, like Timmy and I got into a big awkward fight on stream.
I heard about it.
Yeah, he was so angry. He was like, this is bullshit. I was like, okay. Yeah.
All right. It's surprising because I don't think I've ever seen Timmy angry before.
That's a secret, Cap. Timmy's two emotions are anger and horny. Hungry.
Yeah. And it's a thin line.
I get hungry when I'm horny, and I get horny when I'm angry.
I think retail movies is a fun, thin line.
It's good. I like it. Retail movies.
Retail movies. All right. Who are we rating?
Well, let's just say who won. We're going to finish the poll now, and it was really close. So it was Ravenous wins with 19 votes. Twin Sitters comes into the close second with 14 votes. Parents at 13 votes, and Last Supper at 12. So very, very close. Ravenous pulls away with the win. 58 total votes with 181. He was licking me. That trailer was just silly business. And I like it. So congratulations to the submitter of that trailer. Which would be,
Really quick. Schwingles. Yes. Yes. I was at that.
Almobes.
Quick trivia about that Race War sketch. When it's my POV, I'm holding the camera. And when it's Trevor's POV, he's holding the camera.
And you guys shot that like way before you had a show.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was just two guys in college being weird. Your neighbors did not like it.
Yeah. Well, pretty much our neighbors were like, it's the same house that like Saturday was shot at. And pretty much our neighbors were like,
super size.
The guys who are under the bridge getting blowjobs from prostitutes.
I do love how you can hear you guys laughing through that one. That's like the funniest thing to me.
When I think about that house, I think about the house from Fight Club where there was like no immediate neighbor and like it was like a kind of industrial area by the train tracks.
Was that the fun house?
No, that was, it was just the queen's house.
Is that the one that like you technically were like in Trevor's room and he was technically living there, but not living there?
Yep.
That's funny.
And there was an animal that was trying to eat through the wall.
Yeah. Very funny. Let me see. Do you have someone chosen for raid?
Oh, let me look.
Sicko Vision up. We've been reading I've been reading a lot of like other channels that do like watch parties. It's been kind of neat seeing what other people got going on.
Oh, there's that Sumo Sunday thing.
Oh, bleachy.
It's Sicko Vision is up. Your choice.
Tommy Wiseau also streams, but I couldn't tell if it was like a live stream or like something pre-recorded.
I went to his stream last night. It looked like he was just showing something that he made. Like he wasn't even like interacting.
Oh yeah. I saw it was like, he was playing video games, but it was like highly produced, you know? And he was like saying one line. Yeah. I was like, did he write this? Like, is this, Lady Petunia says it's boring. You don't have to raid anyone if you don't want to. Sure, Panini Mini, but you know, we like to spread love. All right, so All Bleach or Sicko Vision. You want to watch something? I don't know what Sicko Vision is watching, or we can go to like Sumo Sundays. What do you think, Sammy?
What do people say?
Elvis DeBresley said, watch something. Sorry, let's go to Sicko Vision.
All right, Sicko Vision.
If you like Sicko Vision, I think Sicko Vision we discovered through the network of Museum of Home Video. was a great channel until they got booted off Twitch, or they just got suspended too many times and they're like, we're just going to do our own thing. So I highly suggest museumofhomevideo.com. You can sign up for text messages. They have a calendar, but they'll text you and be like, hey, we're going live. And it's only on their channel, not on Twitch. But it is great. There is a chat. If you have a Patreon, you can watch all the old episodes. And that's a lot of times during the week, I will watch like a bunch of their stuff. And I would love to see if they would let us like also play some of their Masterpiece Theater stuff for watch parties, because it is fun as shit. All right. Thank you guys very much. Keep an eye on the Nate Blackest space during the week, and we'll probably be watching something.